Welcome back. It's a spectacular sight from any angle, the Northern Lights or Aurora Borealis. The atmospherical phenomenon is familiar to many, but scientists are still studying the lights for a better understanding of our natural world. News Nation correspondent Nancy Liu went to Alaska to meet the scientists on the leading edge of this research.
The beauty and wonder of the Northern Lights have mesmerized many for centuries. This natural light show put on by charged particles from the sun is a regular wonder this time of year in the interior of Alaska.
Even at the lowest point, it's 60 miles up above the earth. But once you know that, it's just the scale and the motion and the color, just all of that, just so different than anything we ever experienced before.
Don Hampton is among the scientists tracking auroras at the University of Alaska Fairbanks. The team at UAF recently discovered that data from earthquake sensors put in by seismologists also produce useful readings on magnetic fluctuations.
It's kind of annoying to the seismologists, but it's kind of interesting to the space physicists, because here's this fairly dense array of sensors that are picking up something that we're quite interested in.
More than 200 seismometers are in Alaska, so that data is now folded in with readings from magnetometers and a number of all-sky cameras. The constant watch is key, since a major magnetic storm has and can knock out infrastructure. The measurements hardly matter to light chasers throughout the world.
The Northern Lights are just incredible. They're like nothing that you see anywhere else.
Tourism veteran Julie Stoppy says people who fulfill this entry on their bucket lists are never disappointed.
I saw the Northern Lights for the first time when I was 10 years old. Mm-hmm. I still remember that night. It just really sticks with you. It's a unique experience, and they're magical.
Chasing the Northern Lights is hit and miss, but according to scientists, the odds will soon improve based on the solar winds forecast.
We should be picking up in the next 2 or 3 years that the solar wind will get more active again. And so that means, for the same time you're at a site where you might be able to see the aurora, you're more likely to see it just because it's going to be more active.
While many have yet to see an aurora for themselves, those who see them often say it never gets old.
It doesn't lose its magic by knowing more about it. In fact, in some ways, it makes it more intriguing trying to figure out what's going on.
In Butte, Alaska, Nancy Liu, News Nation.